G'day legends, welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to show you the best moto vlog setup I've ever had right here, brand new for 2024. This is going to be a game changer. Stick around for this. All the gear that I'm going to show you here I've purchased myself, so there's no affiliates, no one's giving me anything. It's not a paid promotion. This is just my opinion on the gear that I found, and I tell you what, this is without a doubt some of the best gear that I've come across, and without a doubt the best setup I've ever had. All right, let's get out on the bike. We'll talk about it a little bit more. Okay, so while I'm explaining to you the best setup that I've ever had, we're also going to be exploring. We're at the back of Stroud at the moment. Road called Mill Creek Road. Gorgeous part of the area close to where I live, up on the way out to the Barringtons. And I tell you now, it's a beautiful day. Bit toasty, but it's going to be a nice day for it. But what we're really here for is to talk about the motovlog setup I've pretty much finally refined and come across. And I just want to share it with you guys, because I think if you're about to get into motovlogging, you've considered it, or you've just started. Look, I had a lot of questions when I kicked off, and I relied on YouTube and many other motovloggers to give me the information that they hold as well. So I thought, well, now that I've found what I consider the best setup ever, I might as well share it with you. So we'll kick off talking about the DJI Osmo Action 4. And this thing is brilliant. Like, I've been a big fan of the Insta 360s and everything, but when I saw the reviews when this camera first came out, I was like, wow, that's going to be pretty impressive indeed. So I ended up picking up the Adventure Combo. So that comes with two of the magnetic mounts. You've got the selfie stick, which is what the Insta 360 is just sitting on at the moment as it wobbles around in the dirt. And the three batteries, seriously, battery power is one of the primo things to consider when you're looking at your motovlog combo. So the Action 4, and everything I do is pretty much set at auto. The only thing I muck around with is the EV specs. And that's just due to like the overall light. I'm usually on minus 0.5. Today I've brought it out to zero because it is quite overcast, expecting some rain. And it does make a bit of a change with your whites that blow out a little bit. But everything else is set on auto. I've got it on a wide setting as well, so that encaptures everything. The ultra wide, look, it's pretty cool for its effect, but it doesn't look right. It just doesn't give it that feel. So I still love the wide. It captures the mirrors, the handlebars, everything that's going on out in front. So that's pretty much perfect for what I use. It's now come out after the latest update for the Action 4. It's now normal color, but it's D-Log, which I think means that there's more data, more information, and the colors are just spectacular. So, and if you just want to throw it out there and put it online, it's very capable of doing just that. You can do all your recording, get everything on, upload it, and go to town. Brilliant. I mean, that's what it's about. When you start off, it's just about getting stuff out there, getting it on YouTube, getting your first videos done, and making it easy, and then learning on the way, because that's what this journey is all about, isn't it? Now, audio is a massive thing as well. So the Action 4 doesn't come with your standard 3.5mm audio jack. It actually comes with a USB audio jack, which you see right here. I've got an Anvil adapter thing going into a Rode lav mic, which I've found to be really, really good. That's been quite reliable. And finally, with the gain settings inside the camera, I've found the best setup for the audio. Now, I have played around with the gain in the minuses, and what that's done is gotten rid of all the engine noise in the background and just focused on voice. But then you had nothing, kind of sounded a bit dull, a bit bland, and a bit just not natural. So when I went out and did a couple of audio tests, I found that when you increase the gain, you've got a little bit of that background noise. as well as perfect audio for your ears. I'm going to turn right up here. There's a place I've been wanting to have a look at for a while. We'll come back down into that later, but we'll just go and check this out real quick. So yeah, and audio is key. So you really need to get that right. That's quite important. So when you start mucking around with your audio settings, if people can't hear you clearly, it, you know, it throws the video off and it doesn't make it as enjoyable to watch and listen to. So that's key. And like I said, I'm using a Rode lav mic. I've been using this mic for years. It's been really good. But now that I've found this kind of setup here, oh wow, this is a little bit not. Oh wow, look at this. That's gorgeous. Yeah, now that I've found that kind of setup and it's working really well for me, I'm not going to touch it. It's how I want it. Now, audio being such a big thing as well, the other addition that I've recently made to my motovlog setup is the Zoom H1N audio recorder. Now, that's currently sitting in my Yusui hydration pack in the pocket. Sits upside down to be able to pick up any and all of the exhaust note and any background noise. One of the hassles I've had when I've been out with mates is that you haven't really been able to hear their part of the conversation, so I'm hoping that's going to pick that up. But I've also found that it picks up the background noise, the that beautiful sound of the twin picks it up really nicely, so thoroughly enjoying that. My secondary camera is the ever reliable Insta360 One RS. That's her sitting right there. And I've still got the second RS using both a 4K boost module and the 360 lens as well if I need that. Just absorbing in all these views. It's beautiful out here. And I'll continue to use those. They've still got great audio. Gain control, which I'm thoroughly loving, and it's awesome picture quality out of that 4K boost module. It's pretty spot on. Now, battery power is one of the other most important things when it comes to your motovlog setup. With the Insta360, I've got four batteries, so one for each camera and a spare, and they don't take long to charge up. And with the DJI Osmo Action 4, with that adventure combo, like I said, it comes with three batteries and that triple battery charger. Look at this dude, up he goes. So, and that charges pretty quick. You'll go up to 80% within the first, I think they say something like 20 minutes, like it doesn't take long at all. And then it trickle charges up to 100%. The biggest advantage I've had with the Osmo Action 4 and its battery life is I'm getting well over an hour out of each battery, and that's a game changer compared to when I had the GoPro and and went down that path. Those GoPros 30 to 40 minutes max. Now with the cameras, both of them, I'm only recording on 2.7K at 60 frames a second. Occasionally I'll do 4K, but that file size is quite considerable, so if I'm doing a short day trip, I might throw it on 4K, but this 2.7K, look at these monitors, look at them. Gonna be plenty around here. I think we're gonna see a bit of wildlife. How nice is that? Yeah, with the resolution and the frame rate that I'm getting right now, I'm actually quite happy with it. So it looks good on the TV. I've got a big screen Sony TV at home, and when I upload anything, I'll check it out on that to see how it looks, plus the computer and your mobile devices. Well, your mobile devices, it will always look really good there anyway, so not too fussed with that. So they're the big ones. That's the major contender I'm using. I've also got my DJI Mini 3 Pro, which I get up and about every now and then. I should probably use it a little bit more this year. And that's always a great addition. Oh, cattle ahead. Let's just keep an eye for the cows. Yeah, that's a great addition to everything. But if you're just starting off with moto vlogging, then my biggest recommendation for you is, you know, get a good camera, a really good mic, Make sure you get a dead cat for your microphone. I've got a grey dead cat just sitting next to my chin at the moment, and that cuts out quite a lot of the wind that's coming up. I've taken the chin curtain out of the Shoei, and I still found that I get perfect sound out of that. So that's, yeah, that's been a bit of a game changer. Hello, young thing, what are you doing? Well, a bit of a water crossing. You blind in one eye, kiddo. That water crossing looks filthy. So, I don't know if I really want to go and brave it, to be honest. These guys have had a go. What's it like? Oh, ultra slippy. Yeah. So, yeah, when you go and get your gear, look, you've got to spend big and you've got to spend money on a good camera. The cameras are, you know, that's your primary means. And then your microphone setup, your audio. And then finally going to get into your editing software. I've used Final Cut Pro for several years, and I've just recently moved to DaVinci Resolve because it's free, and the free version does a great job as it is. But get out there and test these cameras, check them out, and go for rides or drives or whatever you do, and go and see what works for you, because they, you know, they can vary. Your frame rates can be different. You know, you've got lighting. If you really want to get into the nitty gritty, you can try your manual settings. They do some great nighttime photography and videography. The Osmo Action 4 is also pretty bloody good when it comes to nighttime, like time-lapse stuff, so that's pretty good. And even in the auto settings, where I've taken it out riding at night, the auto settings are still pretty good as well. It does have a low light setting, but you've also got to have everything else set up for that to actually work. So in most of the auto settings, I found I haven't had the ability to have the low light function, but I still found it really good. And I don't drive or ride, I should say, at night that much at all. Up end of the road, there you go. Hardwood plantation. So that's as far as we're gonna go. It's still a nice piece of country, isn't it? Look at it. Cool. Now, if you've got any questions about any of the motovlog gear that I've got, just let me know. There, the main kit is your camera, your mounting gear. I'm also using chin mounts as a chin mount for the Action 4, and with that magnetic mount, if you go and get a handful of other magnetic mounts, oh, it's so easy to maneuver around and flick to other spots. It's the same with the Insta360. That thing there, to be able to slip that out, change batteries, or put it in another spot, or change out the lens, it's really, really good. So make sure you have a look at this gear. Throw me a question if you've got any. Put your comments down below. This is without a doubt the best moto vlog setup that I've ever come across in my time of getting out riding and sharing my rides with you guys. I can put some links down below. Those links might be affiliate links, so at no cost to you, I might get a little bit of a kickback. But again, you've got to go and find out what's going to be more cost effective for you. So have a look at it, check it out, and just, yeah, throw me a question. Don't be a stranger. If you've got questions, fire away. Be more than happy to answer those. Now, with my settings in the Osmo Action 4, you've got Rocksteady, Rocksteady Plus, and Horizon Lock, or Horizon Steady. And they are great features on this camera. I keep it on Rocksteady. Rocksteady Plus is pretty good, but it does crop in your picture a fair bit. But this is... This is the one I'm using the most at the moment. 60 frames a second, so it does create a bigger file. But I'm just finding on some of the bigger TV screens, it looks a lot more natural. And if you want to talk audio, so this is the background audio with just the camera. And and then the background audio with the Zoom H1N included. So pretty good sound quality, really happy with that. There's certain settings on the Zoom H1N that I still need to play around with a little bit. I'm still getting used to it and seeing what works. So far, most of it's automated at this stage. And I'll put the settings for the H1N up here, along with the settings for the Osmo Action 4, just here. And the settings I've been using in the 4K boost mod in the Insta360 ONE RS. And I just leave it at that. And I, like I said, I'm only changing the EV settings depending on how much light is out there. I do have ND filters for the Insta360, but to be really honest, don't really use them. But I suppose when you get further into it and you understand it a bit more and you're looking for a specific kind of look, then, you know, you'll probably want to check it out and, you know, test it out, play around with it, see what works and what doesn't. Whew. Back on the road. So you can see now the sun's come up a little bit more, it's a little brighter, the clouds are breaking up just a little bit, and it does look a little more pleasant, doesn't it? So there you go guys, that's my best moto vlog setup. Great way to kick off 2024, and if you're really keen to do some moto vlogging, come out and do it. Go and get the gear, make your first video, and get it online. Go and do it. That's the biggest thing that holds anyone up is that they hesitate and procrastinate. Go and record something, play around with some editing gear and throw it online. Do it for sure. It's great fun. This is a great hobby for me. I love it. It keeps my mind off work, gives me something to do and to think about, and it's yeah, it's really good fun. So if you've got any questions, comments or anything like that, throw them down below. I'd love to know what your thoughts are. And we'll see you, and I'd love to see your channel out there on the tube very soon. Ride safe, be good.